It's so simple, the concept that cinema is an expression of images. Images being formed by the combination between light and darkness. In fact, Leonardo da Vinci used to say that the marriage between darkness and light creating children. They call it the colors. Isaac Newton, in his experiment, watching the beam of light arriving on the prism, light colored come out because when the energy, visual energy, passing from one material, they were at one kind of density to another material with different density split. And so he recognized they were red, orange, yellow, green, blue, indigo, violet. Those is a kind of, let's say, element for visual art. Practically, when we were filming in black and white, we have the chance to have a black, gray, and white. Now we have much more tonality. After black, you have also red, orange, yellow, neutral, green, blue, indigo, violet, and when they're all together, you have white. So like you have a piano with much more tonality. Each one has its own singularity, because light is visual energy. Visual energy arriving on you, like this light arriving on me, I don't see this light only with my eyes. I feel this light with all my body. The body is like, according to Hippocrates, Hippocrates was considered the father of medicine in Greek, ancient Greek time. He was studying the behavior, the feeling of the physical human body in relation to different elements, air, fire, water, whatever, or visible energy as well. Energy arriving on us doesn't touch only the eyes, touch also the body. It's been scientifically proven that the more the light increase the level, and the more metabolism, the blood pressure increase. The more the color moving from red to blue, you have the chance to see the variation of the metabolism and the blood pressure. So you have a different emotion. So if you know this theory, if you study the symbology, the physiology, the dramaturgy, a color, you know how to play with it. You know how to, which one can be appropriate to use, connected with one story, one character, one set, one period of time. They represent your past or your future, your present, your love, your hate, your whatever. This is a language of color. It's like a musician has the note to play. A writer has the word. We have the relationship between light and darkness, including all the color. In cinematography school, particularly at the time when I was studying in the 60s, we were teaching in black and white. They didn't give to us any knowledge about the meaning of color. And they were teaching mainly technology. Most of the schools still do that. And this, I think, is appropriate in one side, but we're missing the other side. We're missing the knowledge of art. We're missing the knowledge of philosophy.
Blu come colore non a caso del pensiero, dell'intuizione, della introspezione, di tutto ciò che riguarda una parte interna di noi.
We need the knowledge of architecture, or literature, painting, music. Cinema is called the ten muses because it nourishes itself from the other nine muses, from the literature, script, from the architecture, production designer, the costume designer, the music, and so on, and so on, and so on, and so on. You know what I mean? Unless you be aware of one moment in your life that you're missing something, that's what I did. And I stopped it after Apocalypse Now for 1 year in order to understand what was inside the white light. And I realized in reading a lot of philosophy books that the kind of symbol the different color tone has, the different light could have, the black as well, the white as well. So at that point I was able to perform with much more knowledgeable idea. So my visual vocabulary was extended. Any profession that we do, you can be a director, you can be a cinematographer, you can be as well as cinematographer, you can be a writer, whatever, even cleaning the floor. Whatever we do, actually we are doing it in the best way that we can, in the good faith, in order to understand if you are able to. You feel the fact that the more you know, and the more you are able to understand yourself, to understand who you are. So using those kind of elements that are appropriate to yourself, to your attitudes, your personality, you discover who you are. And that's the most important thing. So that's I learned when I understand that I was ignorant. I knew technology, very important, but I never knew about art. So unless I put these two together, technology and art, and I become much more mature, more in equilibrium with my chance to express myself.